Grafana plugins are powerful tools that enhance your Grafana experience by providing new ways to visualize data, connect to various data sources, or develop complete applications within Grafana. Hi, I'm Tom, one of the developer advocates here at Grafana Labs, and today you'll learn how to get started on your plugin development journey by scaffolding a plugin, setting up an efficient development environment, and exploring the core structure of a plugin within Grafana. Before we get started, it's important to note that Grafana plugin development is supported on all three major operating systems. This includes Linux, macOS, and Windows. For Windows users, you'll need to install the Windows subsystem for Linux to run some of the commands we'll cover in this guide. You should also make sure that you have all of the necessary tools installed to build and run your plugin. This includes Go, Mage, Node.js, and Docker. You can find the links to installation guides for each of these in the video description. Let's get started by scaffolding a new plugin with a single command by using our Create Plugin CLI tool. We'll do this by running the npx @grafana/createplugin@latest command in the terminal. You can also use pnpm or yarn if you prefer. The commands you'll need to run for those tools is on the screen now. Once you run this command, the CLI tool will prompt you with several questions to define your plugin's configuration. First, you'll be asked what kind of plugin you'd like to create. There are four options available to you. An app plugin allows you to provide out-of-the-box experiences integrated within Grafana. This includes custom pages, UI extensions, and is also the option to choose if you wish to bundle multiple plugins together. A data source plugin allows you to connect Grafana to new data sources where they can be queried to produce visualizations inside of dashboards. A panel plugin lets you introduce new ways to visualize data or provide widget-like functionality within a Grafana dashboard. And finally, an app with scenes plugin is a variation of the app plugin option, which comes pre-configured to use the Grafana Scenes SDK for creating dynamic dashboards within app pages. Scenes apps have become the new standard internally when we develop integrated application experiences within Grafana, but both app and scenes app plugins are fully supported, so feel free to choose whichever one suits your needs when developing an app plugin. If you chose any other plugin type than panel, you'll then be asked whether you would like to add a backend component to your plugin. This allows you to support server-side functionality such as calling external APIs and writing custom backend logic. In this example, I'll choose to include backend functionality, so that we can take a look at how front-end and back-end logic are separated within the plugin's code structure. Next, you'll be asked to specify the plugin's name and your organization name, such as your personal name or your company's name. With the plugin scaffolded, it's time to take a look at the anatomy of a Grafana plugin. The plugin folder itself follows the naming convention of organization name, plugin type. Opening up the plugin folder in an editor like VS Code, you'll see a number of files and folders that make up our plugin. A lot of the files in the root of the plugin directory are configuration files required for building, running, and testing the plugin. These files, such as tsconfig.json, jest.config.js, and playwright.config.ts, can be left as is unless you have very specific reasons for modifying them. The most important things to look at are the source directory, which contains all of your plugin's front-end code, and the package directory, which contains all of your plugin's back-end code, if you chose to include one. Opening up the source directory, you'll see a plugin.json file. This file contains all of the metadata that describes your plugin. It contains the information you provided during plugin creation, as well as additional metadata that will become part of your published plugin's information in the Grafana plugins page, as well as on our community plugins site. It's important to keep this file up to date with appropriate information, such as description, images, and links to further documentation or contact details. This file is also where you'll list any dependencies your plugin has, such as the version of Grafana that your plugin supports, and other plugins, if any, that your plugin depends on to function. The other main file to be aware of within the source directory is the module.ts file. While we won't cover this file in detail in this video, you should know that this serves as the entry point for your plugin's front-end code. You should also be aware that front-end plugins are written in TypeScript, and front-end components such as panels, query editors, and configuration pages are typically written using React. Jumping over to the package folder, This is where your plugin's backend code lives, if you chose to include one. The code within this folder is written in Go, which is the same language that Grafana itself is written in. The main entry point here is the main.go file, as is standard in the Go ecosystem. Again, we won't cover the ins and outs of what each file does in this video, but the main bulk of your plugin's backend code will typically reside within the plugin folder. Here is where you'll write code for things such as your app's plugin's backend, your backend data source, or your plugin's resource endpoints. Let's now take a look at how to build and run your plugin within a Grafana development environment via Docker. There are a few key steps you'll need to take depending on what kind of plugin you've created. From the terminal, you should navigate to your plugins directory and run the npm install command. This command ensures that all of the appropriate JavaScript packages that your plugin depends on are installed. Once done, run the command npm run dev to build and run the front end in development mode. This command will continuously monitor your plugin's front end code for changes and rebuild them for you when they occur. If your plugin includes a backend, the next thing you'll need to do is build the backend code using a tool called Mage. You can do this by opening a new terminal tab and running the command mage-v build:linux. It's important to be aware that this command will not monitor your backend code for changes, so you must rerun this command whenever you make a change to your backend code. Finally, to run the development Grafana environment, you should run the npm run server command. This command will spin up all of the appropriate Docker containers and expose the Grafana instance on port 3000 on your local machine. Another important thing to note here is that you must rerun this command if you make any changes to your plugin's configuration files, such as the plugin.json file I mentioned earlier. Your Grafana plugin project comes configured with a number of useful commands out of the box. You can find these listed on the screen now. You can always find these in the package.json file in the plugin's root directory, or from the Getting Started page in our developer documentation. With your Grafana plugin's development environment up and running, head on over to localhost:3000 in your browser to access Grafana. You'll see that your plugin has been automatically installed and provisioned for you, and you'll find your plugin listed within the Administration, Plugins and Data section in the sidebar. For data source plugins, you'll find your data source has been automatically provisioned under the Connections Data Sources section, and for panel plugins, you'll see that a demo dashboard that includes your panel has been provisioned under the Dashboard section. Finally, for app plugins, you'll see that your app is now listed under the Apps section in the sidebar. Congratulations on getting your basic Grafana plugin up and running. This is just the beginning of your journey into the powerful capabilities of the Grafana plugins platform. To dive deeper and expand your skills, visit our developer documentation portal at grafana.com/developers. There you'll find comprehensive guides and resources that help you develop, refine, and perfect the plugin you envision. But developing your plugin is only part of the journey. Next, you'll need to package, sign, and publish your plugin to make it available to the Grafana community. Stay tuned for upcoming videos where we'll cover these crucial steps in detail, ensuring your plugin is ready to launch and can be enjoyed by Grafana users worldwide. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you won't miss out on our future Grafana for Developers tutorials. Take care, and I'll see you in the next one.